My dear friends, I warmly welcome you all to today's session of your QuickBooks training course. If you guys remember, so we were actually discussing about our treatments of sales tax in our QuickBooks, all right? So my dear friends, let me take you guys as a quick revision so that we can see how can we actually invoke our sales tax on our invoices whenever we invoice our different customers, all right? So let us suppose that we are generating an invoice for Mr. Nadeem Beg, all right? And here we select different items from our list. Let us suppose that this particular customer is interested in obtaining some services from our business. Let us suppose that he's interested in obtaining this concrete service, all right? And let us include the quantity. Let us also include the price. And let us categorize this item as a taxable item. Let us also introduce another item in our invoice and let this item also be a service item. And let us suppose that he is interested in our plumbing services, and let us suppose that the quantity per square feet or any other standard according to which this particular item is actually calculated be 50. This is basically the amount, and let us also categorize this particular item or transaction as a taxable item. My dear friends, you know that this is the standardized tax that is always deducted from our invoices, that is always collected from our customers on behalf of this federal authority from our customers, all right? Now, my dear friends, if there is some other sort of tax that we want to invoke on this particular invoice, so basically the impact of that tax will be shown in our invoice as an item. So let us suppose that other than the federal authority tax that is applicable on this invoice, this particular sales transaction is basically taking place in the province or a state that also collects tax on each transaction that is actually being performed in that particular province. All right. So for this purpose, first of all, we will include a subtotal item. And the reason of adding a subtotal item is that it will actually add up the whole amount of this invoice, and then we can easily include another tax amount, tax item over here. For this purpose, let us assume that we are interested in the provincial authority tax charged at the rate of 5%. And now you know that QuickBooks, whenever we actually include any tax item, so it calculates the rate is actually applied on the item that is immediately above it. All right. So now 5% rate is applicable on the amount of 16,000, as you guys can see. But my dear friends, sometimes it is also possible that in a single invoice, whenever we are dealing with a particular customer, so that particular customer might be living in a particular area where the local authority is also charging some sort of tax. As I might have told you earlier, that whenever we talk about sales tax, so basically sales tax can be collected either by the federal authority, it can also be collected by the provincial authority or the state level authority. And sometimes, as you know, that whenever we are talking about a particular state or a particular province, so a province might consist of several cities. And in each city, there is a particular local level government as well. Sometimes, according to the laws and regulations that deal with the taxation principles in a country, so it is also possible that whenever a particular kind of sale is taking place in a particular location, so the local authority might also be taking some sort of tax for that particular transaction. So my dear friends, if this is also the case in this particular invoice, that a local authority is also, you know, charging tax on this particular sales that is being taken place. So let us now add another tax over here that is actually for the local authority. Local authority tax to be collected at the rate of 2.5%. Now, my dear friends, you will see that actually the amount that is charged over here is 0 rupees or £0 or $0, whatever the currency is. Why is this so? Because the tax item, whenever it is included in an invoice, the rate will be applicable on the item that is immediately above it. In this case, the item that is immediately above the local authority tax item is basically the provincial authority tax item. And it is never possible that a tax is calculated on another tax. All right. So my dear friends, There are two ways of dealing with such a situation. All right. The very first thing is that you calculate individual tax on this item, each individual item, but this will make our invoice a lengthy invoice. Moreover, it will also lead towards confusion. All right. So my dear friends, let me tell you that if let's suppose there are more than one kind of tax involved in a particular invoice, so how do we actually deal with them? For this purpose, my dear friends, we make an item, all right, and that item is basically a sales tax group item. For this purpose, as you guys have seen, we will go to the list menu on the menu bar and we will select the items list that is already available in front of you on your screens. Now we will select the items menu from the bottom left corner of the screen and select a new option. And here we have to select the sales tax group item. All right. Let us suppose that we are interested in making a sales tax group for provincial plus local tax group. All right. So here you can also write the description. Sales tax charged by the provincial and local government. So, my dear friends, over here in these columns that you see, you have to select the specific sales tax items that you want to include in this list. All right. So, my dear friends, you select the provincial authority tax, it will be included along with its rate and the agency that is responsible for its collection. And the other item that you would include in this particular column would be the local authority tax, because you are willing to include these two taxes in your particular tax group. All right. So my dear friends, over here, the local authority tax has also been included with its own rate. And together, when you will sum, you will see that the total rate is equals to 7.5%. All right. So my dear friends, over here, we will include these tax items. All right. And now you can see that we had included the provincial authority tax at the rate of 5%, whereas we had created the local authority tax at the rate of 2.5%. And where did we get this information about their tax rates? Obviously, we got them from the tax regulations that have been set by the particular government. In the country in which we are actually operating our tax business. All right. So my dear friends, we will just select OK over here and our particular sales tax group item will be created. Now, my dear friends, as a token of reminder, let me tell you once again that how do we create different sales tax items? For this purpose, we will always go to the list menu and select our items list that is already available to you guys on your screens. All right. You will always select the item menu and select a new item. And here you will select your sales tax item in the service dropdown. Over here, you can make any sales tax item. For example, let me create an item over here. State level tax. And let me give you description. Sales tax collected by the state authority. All right. And here you will select the tax rate. And obviously this tax rate would be that rate that your tax authorities will actually let you know about. So let us assume that this is basically 0.5%, and obviously, you have to select the agency that will collect tax on your behalf. So we will select add new. Over here, you will select the agency, State Board of Revenue, and you replicate this name over here again. And it is also possible that you just enter an abbreviation over here, whereas you write the full name on the option that you guys can see in the list over here, and you can just select OK, or you can select the payment settings, the tax settings, all right, or the account settings. You just select OK and your vendor has been created. You just select OK and another sales tax item has been created in your list of items in QuickBooks. All right. So my dear friends, let us now go back to our invoicing section and see whether now can we create different, can we create an invoice in which more than one kind of tax is incorporated. So here we will select our customer. Let us suppose that this is Mr. Nadeem Beg once again. And here we will select the items. Let us again select the items that he previously chose, concrete and plumbing. We select the quantities over here. We select the price. And we also select these items as taxable items rather than being non-taxable. Now remember, in order to make a particular item taxable, you always have to go to your edit menu and go to preferences. All right. Once we'll go to preferences, you will have an option of making different items taxable and declaring other items as non-taxable. For this purpose, you will select this option, add sales tax item, and you will select inventory parts, and then you will mark them as being taxable or being non-taxable. All right. So here, since we are already gone through this process, we are not repeating it again. So my dear friends, now I want to invoke tax over here. Before that, let me add a subtotal item. Or even if I do not add a subtotal item, I simply will just select that sales tax group over here. Now, my dear friends, since I selected the sales tax group over here rather than our traditional tax, so my dear friends, what will happen? That the tax will be deducted at the rate of 7.5%. However, we know that individually the provincial tax is the provincial authority is charging tax at the rate of 5%, whereas the local authority is taxing collecting tax at the rate of 2.5%. So in the back end, basically, the tax will be recorded for each sales tax authority according to the rate at which it individually collects tax from each customer. All right. Now, my dear friends, let's suppose that the standard sales tax is also applicable over here. So we have an option. You can either select subtotal from here, and over here you select your authority, federal authority tax, and here the tax for the federal authority will be charged over here. Or you have an option that when you are making a sales tax group, so you can include more than two types of tax. All right. So basically you can have many permutations and combinations for making a sales tax group. And once you have added all this piece of information, so you can just select save and close or save and new if you have to generate another invoice. And my dear friends, this particular invoice would be saved and the tax would also be recorded. Now, my dear friends, a question might come in your minds that why can you not actually, instead of incorporating the federal tax over here, why do we not incorporate the sales tax group over here? So let us try. We cannot actually include a sales tax group in our items list within an invoice. All right. So whenever we want to incorporate a sales tax group like we have incorporated over here in this invoice, we will always choose it from the tax drop down menu at the bottom of the invoice. All right. And we will select the group over here. And on the other hand, we will select the standard tax over here unless we have not included it in our group. So my dear friends, here I save it and close it. And now our invoice has been recorded. My dear friends, this is how we can invoke a tax that has to be collected by more than one tax agency in a single invoice. All right. So my dear friends, let me tell you guys another thing. It is possible that in our accounts department, in the business in which we are basically looking after the different accounting treatments, it is possible that not all the employees that are working in the accounting department are actually qualified accountants. This means that some people might just be employed as data entry operators. And in order to facilitate the data entry operators who are actually not very much involved in the field of accounting, and they need guidance on each and every step. So in order to make their life easy and facilitate them, we can actually attach a particular tax rate or a particular tax authority to different customers. For this purpose, let us go to our customers list and enter the customer center. Here, my dear friends, you have accessed the list of your customers. Now, if I want to attach a particular sales tax rate or a particular sales tax authority to, let's suppose, Mr. Bilal Anjum, for this purpose, I will have to edit this customer either from here, or I can simply double click over here, or I can edit him from this particular menu item. All right. So my dear friends, when I will have the information, the editing option available for a particular customer, I will just have to select the sales tax settings. And over here, let me make sure first of all that this person is liable to pay tax or not. All right. If he is liable to pay tax according to the tax laws that are prevailing in a particular country, so I have to select the tax code of TAX. All right. Whereas if this particular customer is exempt of tax, and obviously the exemption criteria would also be provided by the government. All right. So we will select a tax code of NON, and this will indicate that this particular person is exempt of tax. Now, my dear friends, in a particular accounting department in the business, how will you verify whether a customer is tax exempt or he is liable to pay tax? The government will issue a tax exemption certificate to a person if he is exempt of tax. For example, he might produce things that are exempt of tax. For example, if I talk about Pakistan, so for a very large period of time, the agricultural income was exempt of tax. All right. Similarly, there are some authorities, for example, there are some organizations who work for the welfare of people. The non-government organizations, the NGOs, or some other organizations that are actually working for the welfare of humankind. So the activities of such organizations are also exempt of tax. But in order to declare them exempt, the government normally issues a tax exemption certificate to these authorities. And it is, you can say, something of vigilance for the accounting department in order to see the tax exemption certificate of customers that claim to be tax exempt before writing a non-exempt, or you can say non-tax status for them. But here we are assuming that this particular customer is actually liable to pay tax. So first of all, we'll have to select the tax item, that which particular item is actually, you can say, a standard tax item that will always be invoked whenever an invoice for this customer will be generated. For example, my dear friends, this particular customer, Mr. Bilal Anjum, is basically a resident of a particular province. And whenever any sales transaction will be made with him, sales tax of that particular province will always be invoked. So in order to facilitate our data entry operator and also even the accountants, in order to avoid repeating the same steps over and over again whenever they generate an invoice, what we do, we just select the provincial authority tax over here as a default tax item for him, all right, and select OK. Similarly, if let's suppose you are interested in assigning a particular tax item to all of these customers, so what you have to do is you have to select edit multiple customers and job. And now we have to see whether this particular column of tax code and tax item is already available over here or not. Since it is not, we have to select customize columns and select the available columns, text item, and also text code. By text code, we mean whether a person is liable to pay tax or not. Let us move it up. Before email, and also let us readjust the position for text code. After the text item. All right. And now we select OK. So now, my dear friends, here you can see that now the text code says that all these customers are actually liable to pay tax and none of them is basically tax exempt. However, if you have to change their criteria at any time in future, we can easily do for any of these customers by simply selecting the drop down menu and selecting the non-tax code for them. All right. Similarly, when we talk about the tax item, so here you see that we had already changed the tax item from Mr. Bilal Anjum. So we can change the item for any of our customers. For example, for Mr. Nadeem Beg, the item is provincial plus local tax group. This means that whenever we will engage in a sales transaction with this particular customer, so basically two kinds of tax will be invoked. One will be the provincial tax and the other will be the local tax, all right? And since we know that for incorporating both these tax in a single invoice, we had created a sales tax group, all right? So my friends, from here you can change the tax item associated with each individual customer or each individual job. And after you have changed these settings, you just select save changes. All right. Now you just close it and we go back to our home menu. So my dear friends, you know that whenever we collect sales tax on behalf of our customers, so obviously this is not something that will go into our pockets and it is basically not our revenue. We always collect sales tax on behalf of different government agencies. Sometimes it is just one agency, and normally in all countries it is the federal authority that is actually collecting tax on all the taxable transactions and all the taxable items that are being purchased or sold. Whereas in some countries, it is also a convention that the provincial authorities or the state level authorities and also the local governments are also eligible for collecting tax. Now, whenever we talk about sales tax, so it is basically an indirect tax. And an indirect tax is basically such a kind of tax item that is not deposited into the government treasury by the taxpayer directly. Rather, there is a third party that collects tax on behalf of the taxpayer and then deposits that amount of tax into the government's treasury. By default, when any kind of tax that we are discussing on QuickBooks is basically denoted as sales tax, all right? So my dear friends, if we have to manage our sales tax or if you want to generate the reports that we are interested to extract about the different kind of tax that we have collected or the amount of tax that we have paid. For this purpose, we have to go to the Manage Sales Tax icon on our QuickBooks homepage. Once you select this icon, this screen will appear in front of you. Now, my dear friends, you can see that there are several options in front of you when you see this screen. First of all, you'll have this option of Sales Tax Preference. Then you have the option of sales tax liability form and sales tax revenue summary form. And then you also have an option of paying your sales tax, all right? Similarly, you also have an option of viewing your sales tax items that are available, the sales tax code list that your business is operating, and an option of adjusting the sales tax due. You can also access help from QuickBooks for any step if you want to. So let us explore all these options that are available to us one by one and then see the things that we have already understood and things that we have to discuss right now. So, my dear friends, when you will select the sales tax preference, you will find out that this option has already been accessed by us by the edit tab when we selected the edit menu and selected preferences. All right. So, again, the same option is available to us when we select the sales tax preference. And obviously, we go to the selected company preferences where, first of all, we select the option whether our business will charge sales tax from our customers or not. My dear friends, you know that if we are already registered with our government, with our tax authorities, only then we are able to collect sales tax on behalf of the government from our customers. All right. So here, my dear friends, you can add the different sales tax items. In order to add the sales tax item, you have to enter the sales tax name, the description, and you also have to select the authority, that means the sales tax vendor from whom you are collecting this tax, and you will select OK, and a new sales tax rate with a new sales tax authority with a new sales tax agency will be established. From this menu, you actually select your standard sales tax item that will automatically be invoked on invoices of all kinds that are actually taxable. Here, by default, we have selected a federal authority tax. However, we can change our preference anytime by this particular menu option. Here, my dear friends, you can select the codes that your business will use in order to identify whether a particular item is taxable or a particular item is non-taxable. All right. So for this purpose, you can either select the tax code that is available to us by default, or you can add a new code. But remember that only a maximum of 3 characters are allowed in order to define your new sales tax code. All right. So here we will just go with the flow and select the by default tax item that QuickBooks is already offering to us. And here, if you guys remember, so we select the, you can say turnover, or you can say the duration after which we have to pay our sales tax to our authorities. So we have selected monthly period over here. That means that after the sales tax is being collected by us, so 1 month after the collection of that particular amount, we have to deposit that amount into the government's treasury. However, we can also select it quarterly or annually, depending upon our agreement with the tax authority, or how the law that is actually being operational, law that is being followed in a particular country allows us. All right. So here, my dear friends, you just select OK. This was nothing new. We had already discussed these things earlier as well. My dear friends, here you can see there are two options: sales tax liability and sales tax revenue summary. So these two things are important. Let's suppose that we are interested in generating a sales tax report about the sales tax liability that we have to pay. So for this purpose, we will just select this option of sales tax liability. And here we have to select the period for which we are interested to generate our report. So let us select this from this option, this calendar year to date. So my dear friends, this is basically a comprehensive report about the sales tax, about the total sales that we have made, including the non-sales, non-taxable sales that we have made, and the taxable sales that we have made, the tax rates that were invoked, and the tax collected on this behalf, and the sales tax payable as at this date. All right. So my dear friends, you can also select your dates from this particular menu. Now, as you see that we have already selected our period from this particular drop-down menu, therefore we do not need to actually fill out dates over here. But if you are interested to find out the tax report in such a customized way that you want to tell your dates to QuickBooks and you want QuickBooks to generate a sales tax report for the dates that we have mentioned, so QuickBooks will actually do this. All right. So my dear friends, you can actually customize your report as well. First of all, by date, on the basis of accrual or cash, by total or by default, ascending or descending order, You can also apply certain filters on the basis of aging, on the basis of amount, billing status, or some other filters. You can also adjust the headers and footers, and you can also select the print setting as well. All right. Another important thing that I want you guys to learn over here is that whenever we talk about this report, so there is an important option available to us by QuickBooks, and this option is known as the drill down option. What do we mean by the drill down option? If you want to analyze our total sales or our taxable sales or non-taxable sales in further details, so we can actually double click on this amount and another report will be generated that will actually let us know the taxable sales, the details about the taxable sales that we have made. All right, the total sales that we have made. The total sales include this and this invoice, this and this customer, and this document. Whereas the non-taxable sales include this and this invoice, this and this customer, and this item. All right. So if I am interested to know further details about this particular invoice, so I will just double click again, and this will result in the invoice that was generated. All right, that is actually included in our list. So here we go back again. Now I'm interested to know the invoice that have been generated from Mr. Bilal and Jum that is included in this list. So I will just drill it down, and here this particular invoice will be in front of my sight. This is how, my dear friends, we can generate a series of reports by a single report. All right. Let us go back to our previous menu. Now, if I'm interested to know the local authority tax that has been collected, all right, on the taxable sales, so I just drop down a drill down on this particular option. And here, if I want to see the invoice that was generated, so this is basically the invoice. All right. And this is basically the amount of tax that has been collected by us on behalf of this particular tax authority. All right. So this is how, my dear friends, we can actually make best use of our sales tax reports, and we can actually drill them down to the extent that we want them to be drilled. All right. And this is very important because let me tell you guys that audit is basically of two to three kinds: an external audit, an internal audit, and a revenue audit. Whenever we talk about a revenue audit, so this is basically the audit that can be conducted by a tax authority. And for this purpose, basically the records that are maintained by a business with respect to the sales tax collected and distributed, this is very important to maintain. And this step that is being provided by QuickBooks is basically, you can say, an application of record maintenance with respect to sales tax. We have quite a detail of record available. You can see that this was the report that was generated initially. We can drill it down. For example, now if you want to see the provincial authority tax that has been collected on the taxable scale, sales or the tax collected, we just drill it down. We see a further customized report. Now, if the tax authorities are interested in even seeing the invoices that were generated in the course, so we just double click it and we will eventually reach the particular invoice that was generated at that time that actually resulted in this amount of tax being collected. All right. So my dear friends, this is basically the application of this particular menu. All right. Now, my dear friends, here we have another option of sales tax revenue summary. We select it, and we also select the date for which we have to actually want this to appear. So let us select this calendar year to date. Now, this is basically the revenue summary. Now, my dear friends, you know what is the difference between having collected something and having something as a liability. Now, you know that basically we are liable to deposit the amount of tax collected on behalf of the government into the government's treasury in a period of 1 month. So my dear friends, when 1 month has been lapsed, then this particular amount becomes our liability. All right. So before that, this is basically the sales tax revenue that has been collected on behalf of our customers. And we can make the same things over here as well. For example, we can drill it down. So another report will be generated. And if you are interested in seeing the invoice that was generated, so we need to further drill it down. All right. So like this, we can have a series of reports and invoices that were generated initially that resulted in the recording of this particular amount of tax. All right. So my dear friends, you can memorize, that means save this particular report for future use. You can also add your comments on this particular report. For this purpose, you will have to select this message icon over here, and you have to write any comment if you want to save this comment as well, in order to make best use of this report. All right. So right now we just cancel it since we are not really interested in adding any comment. All right. So we just go back to our previous menu. We can also customize this report, as I already told you guys. You can also see some of the advanced settings. All right. So this by in use, we mean the particular balances that we are using currently. However, if you want to include all options, so then you can select the all option. All right. This is basically an advanced options menu. You can further explore it down when you are using these options while actually maintaining some sales tax reports. All right. You can also print your report, or you can save it as a PDF. You can email it to any of your colleagues, and you can also extract this report in Microsoft Excel, because when you have, extract data on Excel, so it can be used for more than one purposes. All right. So my dear friends, this is basically the use of these menus that you can easily access on the sales tax managing icon on the home tab. My dear friends, now let us see how can we actually pay our sales tax. For this purpose, you must need to have an account registered with QuickBooks. So you have an option to either register it, or you have an option to decline it right now. Let us see the option that is available when we select yes. So here, this is basically the same menu that was accessible to us when we were actually establishing the chart of accounts. All right. So here we select the account type. Since we are interested in creating a bank account, so obviously by default, the bank option is selected. You select the account name. For example, you select ABC bank account number, any title, or you can also add the title of the account. For example, if it is in your name, so you can say user one account. All right. So it can be the title name or the account number. Here you can write the description and the bank account number over here. By account number that I mentioned over here, I meant that you can write the name of the bank, and afterwards you can add a user. All right. So my dear friends, once you will save and close, your bank account will be established with QuickBooks. But right now we're just canceling this option. My dear friends, this is basically the thing that we are interested in discussing. Normally, my dear friends, in different countries, in most of the countries around the world, the methodology that QuickBooks is adopting is actually followed in order to pay sales tax to the revenue authorities. That means that we can pay from account, we can pay through check, or we can pay through any mode. Since we do not have any account associated over here, so we will just neglect this option. Or if you want to add a new account, so again, this particular screen will appear in front of us. All right. My dear friends, if we want to select the date, so here you can select the calendar item, select check date. Let us make it from January 2020 to August 2020. All right. Let this be our date. And once we have selected the date, so all the amounts of tax that are due for payment will appear in the list in front of you. Now, my dear friends, if you want to pay certain taxes to certain authorities, we will just have to select the authority on the left column, and the amount will automatically be fetched on the extreme right column. All right. Now, my dear friends, this is something important. The first column will suggest which tax to pay and which tax is actually not required to be paid right now by your business. The second column is actually that amount, the tax item, the federal authority tax or the local authority tax or the provincial authority tax, whatever is actually payable. The third column is actually letting you know about the vendor for which you are actually paying this tax. The fourth column is telling you the amount due. And the fifth column will automatically fetch the total amount that is actually payable. However, if let's suppose I'm interested in not paying the full amount, rather I want to pay, let's suppose, half of the amount, so I have an option. So rather than paying complete amount of 27,302 rupees, so I may pay, let's suppose, 17,000 rupees. All right. So I have an option of actually deciding the payment that I am paying to a particular tax authority. However, my dear friends, it is advisable to always pay and completely satisfy your tax authority, your tax liability, so that whenever you are actually about to pay the tax for the next period, so you have no, you can say, carried forward liability from the previous year. All right. So, however, still QuickBooks 2 gives you an option so that you can pay the tax amount of your own choice. All right. So let's suppose that we are just interested in paying the tax for the federal authority tax and the local authority tax. So we can select OK. Since we do not have any bank account associated right now, so our request will not be processed. However, had there been any bank account associated over here, let us just create an account for the sake of understanding. User 1, description, bank account for tax purposes. Let us add a hypothetical bank account number. If you are interested in entering an opening balance, you can add it. For example, let us add a balance of 80,000. All right. Select OK. And now you just save and close. Now, my dear friends, we are using this particular account. All right. We now select OK. Okay, let me tell you guys that if you want to clear this selection, so everything will be cleared once again. All right. So if you think that this is basically something final, so you just select it and select OK. If you want to adjust it, this is basically some sort of adjustment that can be allowed to you by your government. As I told you, my dear friends, if you remember, sales tax is collected and paid in two, you can say, stages. One kind of tax is known as the output tax, and the other kind of tax is known as the input tax. Input tax is basically the amount of sales tax that you have paid when you were purchasing your inventory from your suppliers, all right? And you had paid that amount of tax to the third party, that means to your vendor, and that vendor was responsible to deposit it into the government's treasury. Whereas output tax is the amount of tax that is charged by you from your customers, and you are responsible to deposit that amount of tax into the government's treasury. But before you actually deposit that amount of tax, you are required to adjust the amount of input tax that you have paid for that authority. And then the remaining amount of balance is actually the amount that is required to be paid into the government's treasury. All right. So this particular section actually relates to adjustment regarding sales tax. All right. So you can explore this option later on. Right now, we're just canceling it. And now select OK. So my dear friends, this particular payment has been processed. And now, let us see once again the status of our sales tax liability. Let us select our date. January 2020 to August 2020. And now, my dear friends, this is basically the sales tax payable by us. You can see that we have cleared our balance for the federal authority tax, also the local authority tax, but yet we still have to make payment of our provincial authority tax that we did not selected earlier while we were making a payment for this sales tax. All right. So my dear friends, this is all for today. And in our next lecture, we will see how can we generate our invoices for customers in a variety of ways and how to deal with different issues that are actually in pursuance with generating invoices. Thank you.